Paddy D live, mate. What do you got for us?
In front of the P3C, folks, owned by the Royal Australian and based in Adelaide, Edinburgh. So they do maritime, coastal surveillance, etc., blowing up submarines, etc. But here we are, live and loud, Avalon Air Show. The weather's turning out nice. Looking for some fast food action. Once again, signing off, Paddy D. Here we are live on location. Cy Gibson. Oh yeah.
He spits out flight controls to all of our jets. He never lets the plane get to a point where it's out of control.
We're talking to an F-16 pilot,
Dave Pittner, I believe. We're up around based in Japan and shortly to be based in Seoul. And he's the F-16 narrator today. He's not a display pilot, but full of much good information. Enjoying the day so far, Shane?
Mate, it's a tough day.
Are we going to see some FJA?
I think so.
Some fast shit action?
We are, mate. We're going to definitely see some FJA.
Live and loud with Dave Pittner. There you go, Dave.
There we go.
Oh, yeah.
Well, you can get my voice on a loudspeaker later.
That'll be good, man.
All my mistakes
can you
for me.
Yeah. Tell us the basic, in 30 seconds, or the basic display routine of the F-16. Today.
Basic display routine that you're going to see later?
Yeah, that'd be great.
Well, hopefully we'll be able to do the high show with the skies that we've got today. He's going to take off into a Cuban 8, or a half Cuban 8 if he's taking off right to left. And then there'll be a succession of flat passes. Sorry about that.
Awesome.
He'll do the high-speed pass. You'll see a triple roll, a knife-edge pass, and then a four-point roll. He'll throw in that 9G turn right in the middle of that. And then following that, he goes into some of his vertical maneuvering. First one that you'll see is the Falcon turn into the Shark's Tooth. He'll whip up, and after about 90 degrees of turn, he'll show you how quick he can turn a left turn into a right turn. Whip right around it with a tucked under roll in mid-center. As soon as he gets back to show center, he'll fly a square loop, square in the corners as he does that. After that, he goes into the double Immelmann. F-16 was one of the first jets to be able to do the double Immelmann. He'll come by and you'll see him complete that in less than about 6,000 feet. What is that? About 2,000 meters? So in less than 2,000 meters, he'll do a double Immelmann, fly inverted over to a split S. After that, you'll see the knife edge pass right then. And then he'll do the max climb with the aileron rolls. And the big thing today, they do a max climb with aileron rolls as well. And whenever we're both in an air show, we count them out loud and try and get the crowd to count with us and see who can get the most.
Excellent.
That'll be about 2.5 to 3 kilometers straight up. And then that'll be the end of his show.
Awesome.
Just about 10 minutes.
Yeah. Well, Dave, thanks a lot for that. And where are you based at the moment?
What's that?
Where are you based again?
In Misawa, Japan.
Excellent.
Northern Japan.
In Denver, Korea. Thanks, Dave.
Thank you. Great. Thank you.
Yeah. With Super Cy, what's going on, Cy?
We've got a kick-ass piece of engineering here.
What is it, man?
It's an FA-18 Hornet.
Oh, yeah. Nice shot of the Hornet. And there's Andy Gibson.
Yeah.
Simulates a low-level ingress, then an abrupt 6.5.
Sally. The F-15 pilot is just about ready.
What are we seeing here, mate?
We're about to launch. We're looking at the McDonnell Douglas F-15 Eagle.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome once again to the Australian International Air Show 2003. I'm your Nigel. We'll start by showing you just how fast the F-15 can get off the ground and climb. This capability gives our fighters in the air quickly to threaten or kill any adversary.
But the in-flight service will commence once Paddy D's on board.
Oh, yeah.